Hi, my name is Sean Olson. In our last video, we discussed a little bit about the differences between world geometry and models and how to tell the system what is what. In this one, we're going to talk a little bit about your materials and getting things to scale right. We're going to start by making a box in the scene. I always start my scenes like this, with a box that's roughly 72 high, and usually I make it around 24. This is roughly the size of a player character. So you should always do something like this to give yourself a sense of reference. If you don't do something like this, a lot of times you'll find that your scene is completely off scale and you run around and either everything is way too small or way too big. So always start your scenes with something like this. I'm going to delete these objects over here. And we're just going to make a little room, a small, simple little level. And we're going to texture it. Now notice that these blocks have no texturing. Any world geometry that you export into Source without any textures on them will automatically get a default dev texture applied to it. But that's not really what we want. We want to give the textures we want. I'm going to open up the material editor and bring it in here. Now, just like Hammer's materials, you can scroll through and find them in Max. The difference is in Max, you need to create your material library. There are other videos that explain that. Right here, I already have a material library called Tools, and it has various tool textures. I'm going to open up another material library that I've already made in the past. And I'm going to bring in CSGO Brick Textures. Now, by default, your system may show little tiny thumbnails and the names of the textures. You can choose to show bigger textures by right-clicking your material library name and display material type as, and choose large icon. Give yourself a better idea of what you're looking at. You can either just take a material and drag it to your scene if you want, and it will be applied to your objects. Or you can drag it into a view. And from there, if you have multiple textures selected or objects selected in the scene, you can hit this Assign Material to Selection, and all of those will get that material. We may want a different texture for the ground, so we'll open up a different material library that I've created in the past. Open up concrete, display as large icons, and here we go. You can type in search phrases that will filter these. I'm going to choose floor. I want one that's got floor in the name, and we'll just use this texture and put this on the bottom one. I want to assign it to just the object I picked. Okay. Now I have two textures in the scene, a brick and some floor. We want to demonstrate one of the default differences between Max and Hammer. And in Max, when you create a new object, by default, it does not have a material at all. And if you're used to Hammer, you'll know that you will have selected a material and that becomes the default material. So let's delete this object and start over. And I'm going to show you a new function in Wallworm. Under Level Design, we're going to turn on what's called brush mode. If I turn on brush mode, whatever the currently selected material in the material editor is, each new object will get that material. And it will automatically be tagged as brush geometry. So now, when I'm making these, they will automatically have that. And if I want to choose another material as the default for the next ones, I just double click on that material, make sure it's the selected one. And now I make my boxes. There we go. It's as simple as that. Now, one thing to remember when you're in brush mode is to avoid creating geometry that would be invalid world geometry. Because remember, in brush mode, it's automatically tagging objects as brushes as you create them. So that's something to keep in mind. And if you want to use different textures on different faces, there are ways to do that too in 3ds Max. It's not exactly the same as in Hammer, but there are similarities, and there are multiple extra tools in Max for this. One thing that's different is that in Max, you will be applying what's called a multi-material to your object. So we're going to create one here. We're going to go to Materials, Multi-Sub-Object Material. And you'll have different slots here. You can double-click on the material and change the number of slots it has available to whatever the number of materials you might need in this. For now, we're going to do 3. So I'm going to show you some of the differences that we can do. And in slot one, I'm going to put the brick. 2, I'm putting the concrete. And I'll put another concrete in 3. And this time I'm going to apply this material to the object down here. What I did was I dragged this output node to that object. The output of the multi-material there. And a box object automatically has a certain mapping where each face has a certain ID, and the ID of a face translate to the material. I'm going to type in brick. And concrete floor to make it easier to know what these are. And I'm going to take this box and then right click, hit convert to editable poly. And I have more options for controlling it, including going into the faces. But by default in Max, when you have a face selected, it's bright red like this to let you know. If you hit F2, it'll be outlined. The edges will be red, but not the faces. So what I have, these faces selected, I'm going to change the ID of this to 1, to be the brick. I go to the top. If I change it to 2, it'll be that. 3, it's that. And that one we already have at set ID too. So any of them that I want to use the same type of patterns, I just use that same material. You'll just apply a different material ID to the different faces. Now if you want to transfer textures from one object to another, just like you would in Hammer with the texture application tool, you want to use Worm Face, which is under Wall Worm Level Design, Worm Face. In it, you'll find a menu like this, where you can select a texture and then drop it on other faces like this. Notice that this does apply convert objects to editable poly objects if that's not what it already is. I'm going to change it, select this one, and change it to this on the bottom. And that's similar to the way you do it in Hammer. Now, what is not discussed in this video is why the UVWs are not consistent between the faces and objects, and we'll discuss that in another video.